Welcome to the module on process of kerb casting. Do not forget to subscribe if not yet done. This module is dedicated to my father. The kerb stones are the members which divides the MCW from the median and shoulders in the road cross sections. The section of the kerb stones depends on the design and choice of the architects depending on the type of the roads. The kerbs can be insitu or precast depending on the volume of the work allotted. For small works and city roads, rate of laying is less, precast kerbs are used for dividing the roads. The foundation shall have a projection of 50 mm beyond the kerb stones and a PCC is laid on the damp surface. The base shall be leveled and slightly watered to make it damp. The in-situ kerb casting is done on the WMM surface. The in-situ concrete should have a low workability as low as 25 plus minus 15 if possible. The kerb is laid using the machine as the production requirements were high and continuity of the front and lay the kerb was available in the project. A smooth finish can be seen as the concrete comes out of the mold in the video. The workability of the mix plays an important role in the laying as too high slump will collapse the slope of the kerb and too less will develop segregation in the mold. The concrete is poured in the hopper and being laid using the inbuilt vibrators to compact the concrete before it leaves the mold so that a smooth finish without air bubbles will come out of the mold. The speed of the paver is maintained based on the availability of the front end concrete so that a continuity of the kerb can be maintained and less joints or joint-free kerb can be laid in the project. During the laying, the dedicated supervision for checking of line and level of the kerb with respect to the fixed string line is ensured for defect-free process. The string lines are fixed to guide the paver for maintaining the line and level during the process of laying of kerb in the project. After laying the kerb and just prior to hardening of the concrete, saw cuts is provided at every 5 meter intervals up to the finished road levels or as specified by the engineer. This is required as without this or in the absence of the planned grooves or cuts, the kerb will develop a zigzag crack, spoiling the aesthetics of the job. The kerb painting is done using a machine for faster completion of work and less wastage of materials. Finally, the termination of the laid kerbs were judiciously planned and fit to site conditions so that aesthetics of MCWs can be maintained.